Have you ever wondered what it's like paddling to the Toronto Islands? Well, this summer we had an opportunity to tackle our fears and paddle across the Eastern Channel towards Ward's Island. In this video, we'll be showing you how to get to Toronto Island by watercraft, including what time to go, where to park, and what conditions to make the journey in. So we just got up and today we're going to be doing the Toronto Island, Cherry Beach to Toronto Island paddleboard adventure, and it's the first time we've done it, and we're going to show you guys exactly how to get there, where to launch, and how difficult it's going to be. So check it out. Now, the best spot to launch your watercraft is Cherry Beach. The beach is a lakeside park located at the foot of Cherry Street in Toronto, and I wouldn't recommend taking public transit here, but thankfully the park has ample parking and it's free in case you're wondering. Of course, like every paddleboarder, the first part of our journey included throwing the boards on top of the car and ensuring they were strapped on securely.
Stop number one is the Scarborough Bluff. We're going to try to get our friend's third paddleboard on top of our car, so it should be interesting because we've never done that before. Here it is. We're moving this on our car.
As you can see, Sarah was successfully able to put the third board on the car, and now we know it's very possible to stack three paddleboards on top of an SUV.
Now I think we were able to get three on top pretty successfully, so. So we made it to Cherry Beach. We're just gonna take these boards off and throw them in the water with the rest of the paddle group that came with us today. And yeah, it's looking like very calm on the water. It doesn't look too challenging. And it's about 8:30 in the morning right now. So looking forward to going across the channel.
The most important tip is to arrive very early, ideally before 8 a.m. We actually got one of the last spots and we arrived before 9 in the morning.
So the walk from the parking lot to get down to the beach is probably like less than 30 seconds. So it's super easy to kind of put your boards, grab your boards and bring them down to the beach. And this is kind of the view when you get here.
As you can see, there's a lot of activity on the beach. You'll probably run into other paddleboarders, swimmers, and of course, a lot of people just soaking up the sun. As you can see, getting in is kind of rocky. So if you have like water shoes, that'd be ideal.
Sarah trying to get on with her boards.
Now we took off very smoothly to the Eastern Channel and we followed the coastline all the way. You know you're getting close to the channel when you pass the off-leash dog park. Now in no time we were able to see Ward's Island and evaluate the Eastern Channel. Honestly, it looks very easy to cross, but believe me, depending on the current, this channel crossing could easily be challenging for anybody. I can't remember exactly, but I believe it took us no longer than 10 minutes to cross the channel. I have to admit, it was a little distracting as we probably had the best view of the downtown Toronto skyline, as you can see in this video.
So as you can see, the channel's a little choppier, but it's still pretty calm. Super easy to get across. And there's lots of kayakers and paddlers and there's literally no boats at all. So if you come in the morning, that's probably the time to come.
As you approach Ward's Island, you will come across a number of houses which are actually privately owned and the land is leased out by the city for 70 years to the owners. I'm a bit of a nerd and had to look this up when I got home, but apparently all sales actually go through a regulated system per legislation introduced in 1993. You actually have to go on a waiting list to be considered for one of these houses, and they only come up for sale every 2 years.
So two boats are coming now, so we're gonna see how hard the waves are actually. Water taxi, and it looks like it's a bigger boat, like a ferry or some sort of like tour boat. All right, so it wasn't so bad, but you really gotta like sit down on your board or you're gonna like essentially fall off with these waves from the boats as a safety tip.
Once you reach Ward's Island, you have a few options. You can either paddle around the island or decide to go in through the Queen City Yacht Club. This is exactly what we opted to do as it was our first time here by paddleboard and we didn't want to push ourselves and go around the entire island. Now the Queen City Yacht Club is located on Algonquin Island, not Ward's Island, and actually was founded in 1889, a whopping 130 years ago. Along the way, you'll also pass by Toronto Island Sup, and I'm sure if you wanted to, they would let you leave your boards here if you wanted to get out and explore the island a little bit.
You'll also pass some interesting houseboats.
Taking a little break, and we found this like amazing like little picnic table like in the middle of the channel that, you know, you should probably recommend stopping at to get some water and food and all that sort of stuff. So
Sarah's eating her granola bar. Now, depending on how far you go, you will also pass by the Toronto Island Disc Golf Course, which I had no clue was a sport until today. It's essentially a cross between maybe frisbee and golf.
Trying to recover someone's disc that they threw in here.
I don't know where it might go.
All right, I think it's unrecoverable.
Yeah.
They must have extras. This guy can do it. You can do it. Let's see. He's gonna do it. He's stretching.
We're now making the trek back, so probably going to be like 40 minutes or so to get back from where we are now in Ward's Island, so let's go.
As you head back, don't forget to take some incredible shots of the Toronto skyline, probably one of the best views of Toronto out there. A final tip, if you're heading back in the early afternoon of a weekend, expect a lot of boat traffic, so you'll definitely need to be careful. Loads of people getting off the ferry. The ferry actually makes a ton of wake, so definitely it's gonna be an interesting ride going through these waves here, so. We'll see. We'll let you know how it is. It's Steve taking one for the team. Sarah's having a bit of a... Woo! Oh my god. You guys got it. Yeah, they're having some difficulty here. It's not too bad. At least we have a nice view behind us. As you can see, there's a lot more boat traffic coming back. There's probably like 10 or 15 boats that you can kind of see when we're crossing the channel. So it's a little bit busier coming back. We're coming back around 11 a.m. So if you are coming back, you probably want to do it on a quieter day. Now, we hope you found this vlog useful as you consider making the trek across the Eastern Channel to Toronto Island. Now, if you want to see other adventures like this across Canada as well as around the world, don't forget to subscribe to our new channel, Toronto Travelers.